Yeah. You too?
No. Job interview.
Great.
Well, we'll see. I found a posting on Craigslist. So.
Yeah. Me too.
Well, you, you look nice.
Thanks. And you look nice and employable.
You. Thanks. Good luck.
Yeah, you too.
Oh, so sorry I am late. This is not like me at all. I am Tess.
Hi, Tess.
You must be Eric and you must be Catherine. Do you forget me?
Wait, I thought I was meeting you here for a date.
And I'm here for a job interview.
And I'm here for both. I'm multitasking!
I really don't think that this is the best way for you to get to know us.
You have 5 minutes of my time. Please, don't waste it. So, tell me about yourself.
Who are you asking?
Both of you.
Okay, well, I grew up in Buffalo, but I moved out here about 6 years ago. I have a good number of friends here, though, so this feels like a
home.
Are you happy with your career to date?
Yes, yes, overall. I've had a variety of different experiences, but there's been a common thread.
So are you happy with your dating career?
Yes, overall. I've had a variety of experiences. Certain type of woman, I suppose, that interests me on a...
What is your long-range objective?
Oh, well, I would say to grow in a way that benefits both me and the company that I am
Eric.
To get involved in a mature, serious relationship where both of us can speak openly...
Dogs or cats? It's just a cute icebreaker. Don't overthink it. Cats?
Dogs.
I prefer tropical fish. Have you ever had a serious conflict? If so, how did you resolve it?
Yes, actually, well, once my boss's business partner, he accused me of trying to steal an idea from him, and it took a lot of grace under pressure, but with patience, I was eventually able to prove that he was the one trying to take credit for my efforts. And in the end, my stand...
Eric?
Serious
conflict.
I was caught cheating with my girlfriend's roommate. Well, at first I tried begging for forgiveness, but that didn't work. I was
what position would you prefer?
Doggy style. I guess that one was for you.
So, I have your contact info, and if
doggy style, eh?
Yes, something about the raw, primal, animalistic purity of it.
I see.
And the once by contact is nice because
okay,
I have intimacy.
Gotcha.
So maybe sometime we could.
Did it?
The grass is young and soft.
Oh, the breeze blows gentle and carries our hopes along.
I feel God is with us.
I feel glory beckon.
Oh, look, a dainty squirrel.
Oh, all nature does please me.
But onward we must wander, for we seek the prize.
We seek the prize.
The last beer in the world. Yay!
No problem, I wanted to see you.
You wanted to check up on me.
No.
You were feeling guilty because you hadn't seen me and you wanted to relieve your guilt.
Well, even if I did, it does not relieve the guilt when you call me out on this.
Sorry. So, we should pretend that I'm clueless and you're selfless?
Yes, please.
Fine, let's take that entrance again. Do it.
Grandma!
Kevin! What a complete surprise to see my favorite grandson.
Yes, Grandmother. I, Kevin, your favorite grandson, have come completely spontaneously, without any ulterior motive, to visit you because of my love for you, and nothing else.
Oh, your display of selfless devotion has reinforced my faith in the next generation.
Let us firmly embrace so that I can suppress and internalize my guilt for wanting to stay away from old people.
Let us hug away my resentment for your lack of showing up and your ungratefulness.
Better?
Much. So good to see you.
I'm sorry. I've been so busy.
Please, just sit.
So, how are you feeling?
I am fine.
Okay.
Stop
Sorry.
Apologizing. And please stop fretting.
What's fretting?
Worrying.
Is that an old person word?
Yes.
Good word.
How are the classes at State? How's your writing?
Oh, it's tough. Deadline's next month.
Then what are we even doing here? You should be working.
It's fine. This is my break.
Coming all the way out here to see me is not a break.
What do you mean all the way out here? I live at the Outer Sunset, not Mordor.
Still.
Look, it's fine. I even made a huge breakthrough on the film I'm working on.
That's great. Let's hear it. Look at that. You actually wrote on paper.
Of course I did. With a pen and everything.
Let's see that writer's body. Look at that. A real writer's box, so proud.
Stop it.
It's true, my other grandchildren don't have this badge of honor. They just use laptops and have bad vision and short attention
spans. Doesn't matter.
Listen to me. This is the hand of a writer. This is permanent. This lasts.
Thanks.
Okay, now, read.
Voiceover. That means it's a voice talking over the film.
I know, Ken.
Voiceover. No one ever told me what to do the day my grandmother died. Yeah?
I'm not dead.
It's not about you. It's just a story.
Okay, I just want you to know it was just a cold, and I got
better. I know. Would you like me to continue the story?
Sure.
Grandmother.
Yes.
What?
Called for me.
No, I said grandmother. That means it's a character in the script.
There's actually a character called Grandmother.
Yeah.
Are you sure this isn't about me?
Absolutely.
Okay, again. It was just a cold.
Yes. Can I continue?
Go for it.
Grandmother, I thought it was just a cold and I thought...
All right, cut it out.
No, I didn't get better. I got worse. As I sat in bed with my grandson reading his story to me.
For God's sakes.
Kevin! That's another character in the script.
Yes, I figured.
Kevin! No one ever told me how to deal with my grandmother's death. No one ever wrote manuals on how to deal with the pain of the human heart.
The pain of the human heart, really?
Probably not like it.
No, I don't like it. Even discounting the fact that you're thinking about my death.
You mean the character's death?
Fuck you, Kevin, it's my death. Death wish fulfillment. This is a very melodramatic play. Manuals on the pain of how to deal with pain.
Come on, it's imagery.
What? Imagery is for bad greeting cards and love letters.
I like the imagery here. It provides a nice contrast to the emotional resonance in the next scene. But we'll see.
A fuck emotional resonance. Fuck it in a three-legged horse at game on.
Can't you just be supportive?
Oh, you mean live?
Grandma.
Oh, you mean unconditional support? Like the daytime Emmys and the Fringe Festival. What is this? You're better than this.
You scared us. I got scared last month when you got sick. I wrote some things down and it helped. I just want people to know how I feel about you and how you getting sick affected me.
Oh, Kevin. My sweet, sweet grandchild. My favorite. I never knew you thought of me as some contrived elderly stereotype.
Come on.
I'm sorry. I know you're being honest and so to speak.
Thank you.
But it reads like a bad eulogy. And a bad eulogy is a good incentive to live. I know you meant well, but you know how I feel about martyring the dead.
It's not martyring, it's remembering.
Fiction is not remembering.
Well, tough. You're dead and you don't have a say in it. You are going to leave me. Yes, I know not today, but you will. And when you do, there will be this phantom there where you used to be. And I know you think it's insincere to romanticize it the way I did here. That's how I want to remember you.
It's nonsense. It's earnest and heartfelt nonsense, but it's contrived. It's enough for your mother and your mother. No more or less than anyone deserves.
Not good enough. Okay, so maybe I overdid it. I am not objective, and I don't care to be. It's not enough to just remember a person, place, and thing. We are not just an obituary. We are not just a eulogy. No one can write down anything that even comes close, but I am going to try. And I will use imagery. I will use emotional resonance, and I will hyperbolize the hell out of you. You do not deserve restraint.
Fuck. But I want a second draft. If you're gonna kill me, do it right. Character development. Raise the stakes.
Okay. Let me grab another drink, then we'll get started.
Give me a glass of something, too.
Water.
Is water something?
Yes.
No, Kevin, water is not something. Try again.
Scotch.
There you go.
Grandma, they don't serve hard liquor.
Goddamn San Francisco liquor board. Yeah, they have.
How about soju?
Fuck that. The Paul Giamatti Osaki, and I don't want anything to do with it. If you're going to be a writer, you need to learn how to drink.
told you.
Shut up and drink it.
Yes, Grandma.
Ha 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 ha!